Hey, what's up guys? Spencer Rhodes here. So the Avengers Endgame is just a few months away. I am so excited. I rewatched most of the MCU movies and kind of fell in love with the franchise a little bit more than I had previously. I also got to where I liked the Russo brothers, the way they directed the movies and the way they're telling the story more than Joss Whedon. A few years ago, I was someone that preferred Joss Whedon and was kind of annoyed that the Russo brothers were directing, you know, the main films and were going to direct, you know, the next Avengers. And I kind of wanted Joss Whedon to direct as many of the movies as possible. But now I'm starting to prefer the Russo brothers to Joss Whedon. And the Avengers Infinity War was a really, really solid movie. And I can't wait for Endgame. I can't wait to see how they've resurrected the characters. A lot of people are saying that either Tony or Steve will die. I honestly think that they could both survive the movie. I don't know who's going to get killed off. I mean, I'm hoping that like they just kill off Thanos. Like, if they wanted to give someone a permanent death, Infinity War was the best time to do it. So I don't know. But it seems like they are going to resurrect a lot of dead characters. I mean, we already pretty much have confirmation that Nick Fury and Peter Parker / Spider-Man, they're both still alive. Even Kevin Feige pretty much said that Spider-Man Far From Home takes place after Endgame. So yeah, I think all the characters that were killed from the snap are going to be resurrected. Because all they have to do is prevent the snap from happening. You know, go back in time, prevent the snap from happening. Literally, all the characters that were killed by the snap, they would still be alive. The characters that I'm worried about in Endgame are the characters that were killed before the snap. You know, there's Ebony Maw and Thanos' children. I mean, those are the bad guys. They can stay dead. But there's also four hero-type characters that are dead, but they were killed before the snap, so undoing the snap wouldn't bring them back. These four characters are, in order, Heimdall, Loki, Gamora, and Vision. At the beginning of the movie, in the first 10 minutes, Thanos kills Heimdall and Loki. And then later on, Thanos kills Gamora to get the Soul Stone, I believe. And then later on, he kills Vision to get the... Which stone is it? Time stone? I'm not sure. But yeah, maybe I got them backwards. I don't know. No, I think he killed Gamora to get the Soul Stone. So no, it wasn't the Time Stone. That was Doctor Strange's. But yeah, I don't know. But he kills Vision to get Vision's stone. So those were the four characters that died before the snap. You know, the four good guys that died before the snap: Heimdall, Loki, Gamora, and Vision. So, I would say for sure Gamora and Vision will come back. We already have confirmation that there's going to be a Guardians 3. There's no way that it's going to be like Star-Lord, Rocket Raccoon, Groot, Nebula, and Drax, like, without Gamora. I mean, they could go that route. They could have those characters on a quest to bring back Gamora from the dead in Guardians of the Galaxy 3. I guess that could work. But I honestly think that Gamora and Vision will somehow be brought back to life. I mean, you know, Scarlet Witch coming back from the snap, it wouldn't even matter if she was alive, probably. She'd be so upset about Vision, she'd almost just wish that she stayed dead. Like, I could see that. I mean, her and Vision's, romance and their love for each other was a very... You know, it's a very big part of their character. So having Scarlet Witch, come back from the snap... And then just being depressed because Vision's dead. I mean, that would be kind of shitty. I mean, again, they could go for that. I don't know. I mean, those could be the permanent consequences that the Russo brothers are talking about. They keep talking about permanent consequences in interviews. Loki and Heimdall, I'm very worried about. There's people that think they should stay dead. I mean, there's people that think that you know, their deaths were so strong and, you know, were such a, you know, defining part of... The first 10 minutes of the movie, that bringing them back would be kind of cheesy. But, I mean, Loki's my favorite character in the whole MCU. I mean, I'm someone who wanted to see Loki I mean, Loki just, he just became a good guy. He just started to really see the error of his ways and want to be a good guy. You know, I was hoping that Loki would become like an Avenger or something. And I think they said that Sif was killed by the snap, but if she was killed by the snap, then if they undo the snap, then Sif is still alive. I mean, I was hoping that Loki and Sif could have a romance. I mean, I saw chemistry between those two. I think Sif is someone that would, you know, she'd keep Loki in line, but like they'd also possibly make each other happy, and she has a lot of that, you know, independence and sassy attitude that I think Loki would be attracted to. I was hoping the two of them would hit it off, but Sif just kind of disappeared because the actress was doing other things. So I don't know. I'm hoping that Loki has a future and that Loki comes back to from the dead because Loki is far and away my favorite character in the MCU. I like Tony Stark and Hawkeye a lot, but Loki's my man. I want Loki to come back. If I go to the theaters and watch Endgame and Loki never comes back to life, I'm gonna be disappointed. And you know, I mean, Tom Hiddleston's confirmed to be in the movie, but that could be anything. So I don't know. You know, with those four characters that were killed before the snap, I'd say there's a good chance that at least Gamora and Vision will be brought back from the dead. Heimdall and Loki, I'm a little worried about. But there were a couple of little lines in the Avengers: Infinity War where it almost seemed like the Russo brothers wanted us to hope that Loki could be brought back to life. Before Loki dies, Loki says to Thor, "I assure you, brother, the sun will shine on us again." Hey, I mean, if Loki comes back to life, then that's made true. You know, that line has that extra meaning. You know, you go back to Infinity War, and you're like, oh, they did foreshadow that he'd get brought back again. And then later on, when Rocket Raccoon asks Thor about Loki, you know, Loki being dead, Thor's just like, well, he's been dead before, but this time it might be permanent. Like the way he says it at the start is like, it's almost like, I don't know. Like, that's not, I don't know. It seems like the Russo brothers knew that they were going to bring Loki back, so they gave Thor almost a funny line about Loki. Like, they just want to give you that little tiny bit of hope for Loki not being permanently dead, or at least being brought back to life. So I'm hoping that all these characters, you know, all these good guys that were killed before the snap, they can come back to life. Because I just that's it. That just seems kind of shitty that if they undo the snap and they bring back the good guys that were killed from the snap, but they can't bring back the good guys that were killed before the snap. I mean, I don't know. That's just kind of, I don't know. But I mean, honestly, I just kind of hope that like everyone comes back to life and they all get together. You know, they all get together and then Captain America's like, Avengers, assemble. And then they fight Thanos and they kill Thanos and they get like a happy ending and the good guys retire. And then we get Phase 4. Then we get Spider-Man Homecoming. That's a bit of a stretch, but I'm not losing hope. It's not over until it's over. We'll just have to see what happens in Endgame. But I wouldn't be surprised if they give all the good guys. Not only do they bring all the good guys back to life, but they keep them alive. They bring them all together. The Avengers Endgame just like culminates with all the good guys together, and they have like this like Return of the Jedi happy ending where they're all celebrating, and you know, Captain America retires, Iron Man retires, Pepper Potts is pregnant, maybe Agent 13 is pregnant. So like these older Avengers get a happy ending, and then Phase 4. You know, I mean, I'm not giving up hope. I mean, it's Disney. I wouldn't put it past them to have that type of ending. It'd be like the payoff after such a depressing film in Infinity War. You know, that ending is going to be the payoff. But yeah, I'm not giving up. I hope that all these guys come back from the dead. So yeah. Anyway, that's all I got. So with all that said, I am Spencer Rhodes, and I will see you guys later. Bye.